In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit. You are listening to Daily Bread Devotions with Father Eustace Siame, a Salesian of Don Bosco. Your word, Lord, is a lamp for my steps. Stay tuned.
This is my daily bread. This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me.
It is Wednesday, the 12th of July, 2023, 14th week in ordinary time. And participating in the proclamation of the Word of God for today are the following Daily Bread members: Dolly Valems Mushayavanu from Harare, Zimbabwe, celebrating her birthday today. Text for us the first reading. Evelyn Zimba from Lusaka, Zambia, who celebrated her birthday yesterday. Text for us the responsorial psalm. And proclaiming the gospel is Father Crispin Okello, a consolata missionary working in Barlovento, Venezuela. Let us pray. O God, who in the abasement of your Son have raised up a fallen world, fill your faithful with holy joy, for on those you have rescued from slavery to sin, you bestow eternal gladness. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
First reading. We are guilty concerning our brother. Therefore is this distress come upon us. A reading from the book of Genesis. Genesis 41, 55 to 57, 42, 5 to 7a, 17 to 24a. In those days, when all the land of Egypt was famished, the people cried to Pharaoh for bread. And Pharaoh said, O Egyptians, go to Joseph, what he says to you, do. So when the famine had spread over all the land, Joseph opened all the storehouses and sold to the Egyptians, for the famine was severe in the land of Egypt. Moreover, all the earth came to Egypt to Joseph to buy grain. Because the famine was severe over all the earth, thus the sons of Israel came to Egypt to buy among the others who came, for the famine was in the land of Canaan. Now Joseph was governor over the land. He it was who sold to all the people of the land. And Joseph's brothers came and bowed themselves before him with their faces to the ground. Joseph saw his brothers and knew them, but he treated them like strangers and spoke roughly to them and put them all together in prison for 3 days. On the third day, Joseph said to them, do this and you will live, for I fear God. If you are honest men, let one of your brothers remain confined in your prison, and let the rest go and carry grain for the famine of your households, and bring your youngest brother to me, so your words will be verified, and you shall not die. And they did so. Then they said to one another, in truth, we are guilty concerning our brother,
in that we saw the distress of his soul
when he besought us, and we would not listen. Therefore is this distress come upon us. And Reuben answered them, did I not tell you not to sin against the Lord? But you would not listen. So now there comes a reckoning for his blood. They did not know that Joseph understood them, for there was an interpreter between them. Then he turned away from them and wept.
The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm is taken from Psalm 33, verses 2 to 3, 10 to 11, 18 to 19. The response is taken from Psalm 33, verse 22. And the response is, may your merciful love be upon us as we hope in you, O Lord.
May your merciful love be upon us as we hope in you, O Lord.
Give thanks to the Lord upon the harp, with a 10-string lute, sing him songs, or sing him a song that is new. Play skillfully with shouts of joy.
May your merciful love be upon us as we hope in you, O Lord.
The Lord frustrates the designs of the nations. He defeats the plans of the peoples. The designs of the Lord stand forever. The plans of his heart from age to age.
May your merciful love be upon us as we hope in you, O Lord.
Yes, the Lord's eyes are on those who fear him, who hope in his merciful love, to rescue their souls from death, to keep them alive in famine.
May your merciful love be upon us as we hope in you, O Lord.
Gospel acclamation is taken from Mark chapter 1, verse 15. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. The kingdom of God is at hand. Repent and believe in the gospel. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Matthew chapter 10, verse 1 to 7. At that time, Jesus called to him his 12 disciples and gave them authority over unclean spirits, to cast them out and to heal every disease and every infirmity. The names of the 12 apostles are these: first, Simon, who is called Peter, and Andrew his brother, James the son of Zebedee, and John his brother, Philip and Bartholomew, Thomas, and Matthew the tax collector, James the son of Alphaeus, and Thaddeus, Simon the Cananean, and Judas Iscariot, who betrayed him. These 12 Jesus sent out, charging them, go nowhere among the Gentiles, and enter no town of the Samaritans, but go rather to the lost sheep of the house of Israel, and preach as you go, saying, the kingdom of heaven is at hand. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We are on chapter 41 and 42 of the book of Genesis. It is a fast forward because yesterday we were on chapter 32, and then you may be wondering what happened. How did we jump these chapters in between? And you tell us that we actually go through the whole Bible at the end of 3 years. Now, how do we go through the whole Bible when we jump a number of chapters in between? Because what we are looking for is the message the Bible wants to convey to us. We know what happened in between after Jacob had that vision. Jacob settled in Canaan, and it was in Canaan where he started tending the flock. He became prosperous, and Joseph was 17 years old when he started having dreams. He was still very young, and he started having a number of dreams, and that made him the favorite of his dad because those dreams were interpretable, and whenever he would interpret a dream, things would come to pass. His dad loved Joseph because he was among the youngest. He was the firstborn child of Rachel and the 11th child of Jacob. And this beloved son of Jacob wasn't loved by his brothers because of this. And this is exactly what happens, you know. When you are loved by God, not everyone will love you. Not everyone will like you. That is exactly what happens in our lives. When you have your dad, God, the Father, loving you so much, you will experience a lot of trouble in your life. Jacob stands for God. God perseveres. Jacob is Israel. Israel means God perseveres. When you are loved by a God who perseveres, then you will have a lot of enemies around you, even your closest relations. And this is exactly what Joseph went through. He was sold by his brothers in chapter 37 of the book of Genesis. And for your information, from chapter 37 to chapter 50, everything is about Joseph. It is like he takes up the main actor's role. He is sold by his brothers. He finds himself in Egypt, in Potiphar's house, an official of Pharaoh and his chief steward. And then there he gets into trouble. But all that was engineered by God because he needed to get into that trouble, showing the perseverance and getting into prison, because that prison was going to be a source of his blessings, because it was from there that he would be known as an interpreter of dreams. And Pharaoh came to know about him when he had that terrible dream of famine, and he interpreted that Joseph found himself in the highest office in the land. He was the food reserve agency CEO. Oh my God. This man became the governor. And now we are here where his brothers now come to look for food. It is here that the plan of God starts unfolding. It is here that things become clear that this is the reason why Joseph had to go through what he went through. You won't understand when you are going through something why something is happening. You will only understand later that it is God's plan. So be patient, persevere, be Israel. God perseveres. And if God perseveres, why can't you also persevere? In everything you are going through, God is knitting out something. God is making something. God is engineering something. You will see the final product. Keep trusting in God and you will see what God can do. The gospel passage of today is the sending of the 12, and it starts today and will go on for a number of days going through chapter 10, which is all about the sending of the 12. Instructions are given. Why is he sending them? Because he's a God of compassion. Why is he sending them? Because he's a God who feels for us, who feels with us, and he wants us not to be left out in receiving the word that gives life. So when you hear the message of God, you know it is the compassion of God working in your life. It is God himself showing his compassion. And he's telling you, you know what? My son, I love you. My daughter, I love you. I just don't want to leave you out. And take this opportunity for your own transformation, because that is exactly what the word does. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Blessed Wednesday to you.
Thanks be to God.
This is my favorite. Your very word. Spoken to is here.